Ah! peace from God our Father
never decide to take it away.
And the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us read together a verse from 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 16. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 16. Live as people who are free, not using your freedom as a cover up for evil, but living as servants of God. Live as people who are free, not using your freedom as a cover up for evil, but living as servants of God.
Directors of ceremony, allow me on behalf of the Commerce inhabitants to direct a particular word of hearty welcome to His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta, the President of the Republic of Kenya, and his delegation for sharing this joyous moment with us. May those ties and bonds that brought us together be the ideal mirror in which our love and desires of a united Africa, one voice, as reflected following the footsteps of the founders of our hard-won independence. This spirit of pan-Africanism must continue to enrich our hopes and aspirations to be one great family with a positive future of solid bridges of brothers and sisterhood and solidarity between our nations. Dear African brothers and sisters, please welcome to Windhoek, the capital city of Namibia, the city of many faces here in the Great Commerce region.
Democracy, good governance, and adherence to to realizing a just, equitable, and prosperous future. Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I must remind you all that today, Africa is borrowing a leaf from the Republic of Namibia on policies that promote gender equality, which have elevated women to decision-making positions since the adoption of the 50-50 gender policy in 2013. Today, we, the new generation of leaders on the African continent, are working to unlock our continent's full potential in achieving sustainable social economic growth and development. Africa has put in place a roadmap under the African Union Agenda 2063 with a view to accelerating progress towards the Africa we want. As we, as leaders and an African people, pursue this noble cause, I want to assure our brothers and sisters in Namibia that Kenya remains steadfast and committed to continue working closely
has flowed for 29 years. We shall never forget its origin. We shall never forget our struggle. We shall never forget the sons and daughters that made our freedom a reality. When we gathered in Bendu 29 years ago, we witnessed the lowering of apartheid flag for the last time and the raising of our national flag for the first time. It marked the transition from old to new. Independence did not only bring with it new opportunities, but new challenges. The struggle for political independence was won, but the struggle for economic independence had begun. As a nation, we have made significant strides over the past 29 years. We have established the firm foundations of democracy, unity and peace and stability, and used them to develop a robust governance architecture characterized by well-functioning processes, systems, and institutions. We have made tremendous progress over the years with regard to fighting poverty. We also made progress in fighting corruption by being transparent and accountable, and by so doing, building the trust for transparency, that's my slogan, for transparency plus accountability equals trust. Very few countries have been able to achieve poverty reduction rates that Namibia has achieved since independence. So on one can assume that with a new targeted approach towards combating poverty, we stand to make even more inroads than before. In absolute terms, more than 400,000 Namibians were lifted out of poverty during the period from 2094 to 2010. Namibia of 2019 is a far cry from the Namibia of 1990. Whether you want it or not, let me repeat, the Namibia of 2019 is a far cry from the Namibia of 1990. This coupled with our hard-won freedom is an achievement worthy of celebrating. Some are saying there is nothing to celebrate. There is nothing to celebrate. Were you a freedom fighter? Were you in Namibia 50 years ago? You knew Namibia 50 years ago? And you are saying today there is nothing to celebrate. Therefore, let me thank you, all of you who are here in big numbers. Some is chasing you away, but thank you for coming out. For some were trying to discourage you from coming here, but you came here to celebrate this Independence Day. Don't stop celebrating it. Don't be misled. We are working around the clock to ensure that we restore economic growth and job creation. 29 years ago, we witnessed the end of the nightmare of apartheid. For the first time, our people could dream of a better life. A life free from shackles of racism and discrimination. A life where one can pursue education. A life where one can maintain a life where all Namibians can share in the beauty and wealth which God has bestowed on this blessed land. Greetings! We know that by virtue of the power vested in me by the Namibian Constitution, I, Hage Gottfried Keiko, President of the Republic of Namibia, have invested, and by these descent to invest.
His Excellency, Honorable Uhuru Kenyatta, CDA. Then Commander of the Order of the Militia Barbados, First Class, as witnessed by my signed honor. Given on this day, 21st March 2019.
As we celebrate 29 years as an independent nation, we feel a sense of gratitude to the leaders of our struggle, all the Namibian veterans and the international communities whose sacrifices and solidarity made our independence possible. Our President, Dr. Hage Geingob, himself a liberation icon, deserves all our commendation for hosting our 29th Independence Anniversary and for his inspiring statement. I believe that I also speak on behalf of all Namibians in thanking our President for honoring our special guest of honor today, being a head of state of a sister African country that has been supportive of our liberation struggle, as we have heard. I also want to express on behalf of the government and people of our republic, our warm appreciation and thanks to His Excellency, Mr. Uhuru Kenyatta, President of the Republic of Kenya, who accepted the invitation from our President on our behalf to grace our independence celebrations with his eminent presence at these commemorations with his delegation. Kenya was among sisterly African countries, as we have heard, that rendered invaluable support to our national liberation struggle. It is thus most befitting and indeed a great honor for us that President Kenyatta is in our midst today at this event. As icons of our country's liberation struggle and former presidents of our country, Dr. Nyoma and Dr. Pohambas share in the credit for the successes that we are celebrating today. Our president and our country have received numerous messages of congratulations on the occasion of our 20th anniversary as an independent nation, as we have heard. We express our sincere appreciation for those messages. The people of Namibia are indeed humbled to know that so many nations and leaders are thinking about us as we celebrate this milestone in our development as an independent nation. The National Preparatory Committee also deserves our commendation for dedication and professionalism with which it organized the event, and indeed all of those that have entertained us today. I thank all of you who are here today and all those who have contributed in various ways to the outstanding success of these independent celebrations. Happy 29th Independence Anniversary in Namibia. Thank you.